Whoa, scrappy little blaze, huh?
Oh my god, the fire's got a gun!
Y'all didn't think I wasn't going to talk about my first impressions without including that wonderful, amazing opening. I gotta say, just getting right into it, this anime has been nothing but fun and laughter for me. I've enjoyed it so far. I am behind, and you can't blame me, but when I picked the animes that I was going to watch at the beginning of the season, I didn't think that this was supposed to be one of them. And I binge-watched it, I've caught up, and, you know, now is the time to talk about it for me before it's too late, because I already have a bunch of other stuff that I also need to review, including, and here's the kicker, another anime. I'm not going to tell you what it is. Another anime that will be coming on to the channel very soon. So I'm just very, very glad that I started watching this. I never skip the opening to this anime ever, because I really, genuinely enjoy this song. It pumps me up. I think of Fire Force. The music is great. It's just one of the most enjoyable anime openings I've seen in quite some time. And another thing that I really like about this is that we actually have the creator of Soul Eater, if I'm not mistaken, being part of this. You can already see in some of the, like, the way the characters are designed, how it resembles Soul Eater. Now, I will say this. I don't think Fire Force is at the same level that Soul Eater was. Soul Eater is one of the greatest animes out there. It is very popular, but at the same time, I feel like it's underrated. A lot of people confuse it with something joking, like it's funny and stuff like that. And, you know, I give them that. It is pretty funny. It can be. But, you know, it had a lot of serious moments, and it was great. I enjoyed it. But what screwed it up is Soul Eater not. Like, that was just blasphemy. Like, that should never have existed. But I know that there are fans out there that enjoy that. I hope that if Fire Force does end, that it doesn't get like a Fire Force knot. You know, I don't want that to happen. But from what I'm getting, I'm also getting, you know, Black Clover vibes. Shinra, the main character, is voiced by the same person that does Asta, which is something I enjoy. Other characters that I certainly like, and I'm watching this both in English and in Japanese, so I'm watching it in both languages, and I find it to be very enjoyable in both languages. Captain Obi is in English, dubbed by Jeremy Inman, who I've had the pleasure to meet, and this man is actually was a firefighter, and I think he was the perfect choice for that role. He's a great Captain Obi. In the sub, he is also very, very well subbed, and I like it. The other character is Maki, who is a witch, is easily, like, you know, just ticked off by, you know, being called a gorilla. Very funny. Very recently, we got a whole little arc about, you know, the priestess, who she actually had an issue with one of the other captains, Princess Ibana, who we actually got a better understanding of. She was quite psycho. I enjoyed the little arc, and of course, there was fan service in that, and I enjoyed seeing that, but I don't think that's the whole thing of it. We also got introduced to another character, and I think that now Shinra's starting to get a little harem here, because we have Princess Ibana, and now we have this other girl, Tamaki, who, like, I believe episode 2 she was introduced, or episode 2 or 3, and through these rookie games, we got to see her for the first time, and she actually has, like, a weird lucky lecher kind of thing. I don't understand that whole situation, but she meets Shinra, who he wants to know the whole reason as to why people are combusting. Why are there these people that turn into, like, these fire-looking demons? And so, it's an interesting concept. I like that. You know, the characters are very enjoyable. We get to see the villain, or at least it looks to be. His name is Joker, or at least he's an accomplice of it. And he gives, like, he shows up in various times now. In the latest episode, we get to see him talking to Shinra. And that was something that I was very surprised about. Like, we get to see, you know, why he comes to him. He knows information, and it piques Shinra's curiosity, and I like that. We also get to see that there's a bigger group out there, the Evangelists, and there's a lot of corruption, both in there, obviously, and in within the units. And so we have this group that Shinra is part of, the 8 group, and them investigating. They first investigate Hibana, and they get her information and all that. And now they're searching for other groups. And now group 1, we get to see one of their, I guess, lieutenants being corrupt. Him being killed by the Evangelists who he was working with. And the Evangelists are actually run by none other than Shira's younger brother, who he had believed to be dead, but thanks to Joker's information, he actually is alive. So it is interesting to see. I'm guessing we're going to get some kind of face-off very soon in this anime between the brothers, which I'm enjoying. I would enjoy seeing, you know, how that would work. But I'm enjoying it. Like I said, this is my first impressions with a mix of a review. But let me know what you guys think. If you guys have been watching it, what do you guys think? Has it been enjoyable? Has it been eh? Or what do you expect? Let me know in the comment section below. And as always, guys, stay safe. Take care of yourselves and others. And I will catch you later.